Hello everyone. Today we will start with the types of viruses. Previously we have understood the categories of the viruses like Trojan horse, spyware, malware and worms. So today we will study about the types of viruses. What kind of viruses are there? Let's go. So here are the types of viruses. Viruses can be classified by their infection targets into the following types. How do they infect? If you know, in your computer system there are three kinds of files. The one is operating system files, like when you install Windows in your C drive. So the all Windows files which are needed to load your computer system, all those files are known as boot files, right? So the viruses which infect the operating system files or the boot files are known as boot viruses. That means whatever the kind of file is, the same, the viruses which infect those files are known as with its name. So boot viruses infect the boot records. Records means files. So boot means booting is a process of loading the computer operating system into the computer. So operating system means Windows. So whatever the files needed for loading the operating system into the memory, right, they infect, these viruses infect those files. So the boot virus becomes active at the time of booting the machine. That means when you start your computer system, at that time the boot viruses becomes active because they harm only the boot files. So booting is done only at the time of starting the system. So whenever you start the system, that time only the virus can harm to the computer. So these kinds of viruses are known as boot viruses. The examples are disk killer, stoned virus. These are the types of boot viruses. Now the next is program file viruses. These viruses infect executable files. Now what do you mean by executable files? Whenever you install or download any app or application from the net and install it into your system, so all those are known as executable files. So whatever the programs you have installed, whatever the softwares you have installed, so the files are always there of every software. So the viruses which infect those software files are known as program file viruses. For example, whenever these programs get loaded into the memory, like their extension is .com, .exe, .ovl, .drv. If the software has all these extensions, to the file, the viruses which have these extensions in the files can corrupt those files. The virus becomes active in the memory by replicating itself and infecting files on the disk. The examples are Sunday, Zname, Cascade, it's also a name of the virus. So these are the program file viruses. Third is macroviruses. Macroviruses use another application's macro programming language to distribute themselves. In very simple language, if I tell you, the macroviruses are the viruses which can harm the user created files. That means any file which you have created using any software. Suppose you have made a drawing in MS Paint and saved it. That is a user file. You created a file in MS Word. That is a document file. You created a presentation. That is also a file. So whatever the files you have created, these viruses are infecting those files which are created by the user. So all those viruses are known as macroviruses. As you can see here, they infect documents such as MS Word or MS Excel. That means whatever the documents are created using these applications are infected by these viruses and are typically spread to other similar documents. So it is very clear ki any kind of document you are creating in any software, the macroviruses are doing harm to those files. So I think children, you all are very clear with all these three types of the viruses. The first, boot viruses, which infects the operating system files. Second is the program file viruses, which infect the software files. Third is the macro viruses, which infect the user created files. So all these three are the types of viruses by their target infectioning targets. Clear? So now we will study about the symptoms of the virus. How will you know ki the virus is there in your system, and their precautions, how to protect it by coming, the virus should not come to your computer, how can you protect it? The protection we will do now, and the symptoms. Let's go. So here are the virus symptoms. A virus can cause problems in a computer in many ways, such as decreasing the speed of the computer, that means by decreasing the memory speed. Second, causing strange movements or patterns on the screen. This may be you will be not aware because you are not using much the computer. So we'll do the another one. Displaying unusual messages like your PC is stoned, kind of any unusual messages coming onto your screen, that is the reason, that can be the reason ki virus is there in your system. Increasing the use of disk space and growth in file size. Suppose your file is of 2 MB but it is showing of 2.25, that means so your file size increases because the virus is attached with your file. Frequent hanging hona, that is also a symptom of virus. Showing abnormal write protect error. Next is reformatting the hard disk, deleting or damaging files. These are the main computer virus symptoms which you are maybe aware also. So all these only you do, rest you can leave. Next is prevention. How can you prevent your system from a virus infection? So every PC should be equipped with antivirus programs. That means every computer system should have an antivirus program installed on them. Otherwise, you cannot know the computer virus is there and you cannot remove without any antivirus program. Always scan the pen drive before using it or copying it. Whenever you use your pen drive, before opening it, always scan it first. And scanning can be done only then if you have computer antivirus program. Do not install pirated software. Pirated means copied software. If you know piracy of the movies, like somebody is going to the theater and copying it by making video, that is pirated. Same way, don't use pirated software. It can contain the viruses. Scan the hard disk twice a month. Always scan your computer system twice, two times in a month. Take the backup of the important files every day. That means always have the backup of the files in your CD, DVD. Save it so that because of the viruses, if your system does not work, so you can get your back files back. Use internet and email attachments very carefully. We have started in the previous video that virus can come from email attachments also, to always download them very carefully. Now we will study about antivirus software. Antivirus software is a software which is used to protect the virus infection or to find out the viruses from your system and removing them. Like whenever a biological virus comes to your body, what happens? You always take antibiotics because biological virus is here, so to kill that virus you take antibiotic medicines, right? Same way, if your virus is there in your system, to remove all those viruses you should have antivirus software. So what is the antivirus software and how to install and what are the important popular antivirus programs are there? Let's read about it. Antivirus softwares are the computer programs which are designed to identify, prevent and remove viruses from a computer. So this is the definition of the antivirus software. These are the computer programs which are designed to identify, prevent and remove viruses from a computer. They perform the following tasks. So these are the tasks which are performed by antivirus software. Scanning, scan the computer files to look for known viruses. Always it scans the computer and finding out the viruses to remove. Next is identify suspicious behavior from any computer program which might indicate infection. That means any computer program means from any computer software, if it finds any kind of behavior which suspects that the virus is there, it identifies and removes it. So simply installing an antivirus software in computer does not guarantee that 100% protection. So if you say ki ma'am, just now you said ki the virus antivirus software always remove the viruses from your computer, but it is not 100% guaranteed, as the installed antivirus program would not be able to detect new virus programs, new viruses which are just created by the programmers just now, and the antivirus program is created earlier. So that viruses could not be identified by the antivirus program. So for that, to avoid all these kinds of things, you should keep and updating your computer with the latest version of antivirus program. Now we always say na, update your app, some kind of bugs are there, fixes are there, some new features are added. So update karne se kya hota hai, that all those features are installed on your system. So same way you have to update your antivirus program regularly, so that whatever the new viruses has come to your system, so antivirus can identify those new viruses also. Okay. So these are the popular antivirus programs: Norton, McAfee, AVG, Picillin and Avira. And the most important, which is not given here, that is QuickHeal. Which maybe you are very much aware of it. QuickHeal is a antivirus software which is very very popular and very very trustworthy antivirus, which guarantees the protection. So all these are the antivirus programs, and this is your homework also. Please draw and color all these popular viruses in your notebook. This is an activity of this chapter. Draw and color all the popular viruses and label it. Give the names also. Clear, children? So here is using an antivirus program.